If you yourself are considering or have any friends that are considering investing in real estate, please send them the link to this video. We're going to look at the irrefutable proof behind why you may want to reconsider investing in real estate. So back when prices were rising, real estate was a decent investment, mostly because of this equity rise. Now today, we do not have prices rising. In fact, many markets, prices are starting to decline, especially in the cities, and are quite possibly going to fall for a while. Now, without that equity increase, traditional rentals are just not that amazing of an investment, as is easily proven. Now, I'll use round numbers today to demonstrate to you. Now, let's say you buy a family, single family, very basic house outside the city for about $100,000 all in, including your closing costs, your repairs, and everything else. Now, how much can you rent that house for? Now, a $100,000 house outside of a city, say $800 a month. Now, it's advisable to keep your prices a little bit lower and more appealing than the competition rentals, so you're going to have a nice list of prospective tenants to choose from, rather than charging more money, being vacant, and being less selective with your tenants. But let's start with $800 as a gross rent. Now, next, let's look at the expenses that are involved. Now, the first expense is taxes. And taxes, they're going to be higher for commercial properties. But let's use the national average. That's 1.19%, which is about $1,190 a year, or about $100 a month. Now, if you're in the state of New Jersey, your rates are 2.19%. So check your state tax rules to be sure of the amount. Now, next is insurance. It's often 20% higher to insure a rental than your own home. Now, the average owner-occupied premium, it's about $850. So let's say $1,000 a year for insurance, or $83 a month. Now, next up is your maintenance. There's a lot of estimation myths, like the 1% rule, where you spend 1% of the house value annually, the 50% rule, where your operating costs are supposedly going to be half of your rental income, or the dollar per square foot rule. None of these are accurate. But I'm going to use 1%, which is way too low, but let's stay conservative. So 1% of the property value every year, we're going to tack on another $1,000 a year, or once again, $83 a month. Now, pro tip, it's never going to be that low. And if you've ever replaced a roof or windows in a house, you know how expensive it can actually be. But even using a conservative 1%, we're already down to $534 from our original $800. Now, I'm not even going to go into the costs involved keeping the house up to code. So inspections for asbestos, for lead paint, if your house was built before a certain year. And what about the fines that you can run into? If the grass isn't cut in some states, you pay a fine. Garbage around the house that your tenants left, you could potentially pay a fine. We're not even going to look at that. Now, next up are the utility costs. If you included those in the rent, which a lot of tenants prefer so that they can control their expenses, you have an additional cost, very conservatively, of $150 a month. Now, depending on gas or electric costs in your region, what you have in the house, how long your tenants are going to leave the windows wide open in the middle of December, your costs are going to vary, but we'll use a conservative $150 a month for heat, water, and hydro. You're now down to $384 remaining. Now, if you do make the tenants pay the utilities, and you buy a house that is poorly insulated and their costs are steep, say $400 a month, which in colder climates is very possible, you're going to have a lot of vacancies. When possible, before buying the house, check what the previous utility costs were to see what you or your tenants can expect. Now, if you're buying a repo, if you're buying something that's bank-owned, you're not going to be able to get that data, so you're taking a bit of a risk. Now, the next consideration, did you use your own cash to buy the property? Or, like most people, are you financing it? Now, if the bank loans you money, they charge you higher rates for rentals because rentals are a higher risk. Rates are even higher for an apartment or a duplex, but let's say 5% rate for a single family non-owner occupied, which is a realistic number. Your payment on a 30-year mortgage at 5 points is going to be about $537. So we started with $800 in rent, which really is the only number people ever consider. Wow, I can make $800 a month doing nothing. But then we subtracted the taxes, the insurance, the ongoing maintenance, the utilities, and our mortgage. So congratulations, you are losing $153 a month. And you'll pay the bank over the term of the loan $93,000 in interest just for the privilege of using their money. But we're not done yet. Now, two decisions remain that you have to make, and that is whether to do the bookkeeping yourself and whether to actually manage this property yourself. Both are a headache. So if you hire a property manager to look in and take care of your property, expect to pay about 10% of the monthly rent plus the expenses. So take off another $100 a month, or be prepared to take calls at 3 a.m. that the heat stopped working or the pipes froze and there's 2 feet of water in the downstairs because the tenant left for a week and turned off the heat. And keeping track of all the finances and expenses and deductions, that's another task in and of itself, and I feel is better left to the professionals. That's going to cost you a bit of money as well. So if we add in these two, you realistically are going to be in the hole every single month between $250 to $300 just for the privilege of this rental property. And that is assuming nothing goes wrong. And believe me, stuff goes wrong. Now you might say, hey, but I know people who did well in real estate. And so do I. But today is not yesterday. You can't step in the same river twice. And most people did well because of the equity rise. Okay? Prices of the houses went up. They made a lot of money with equity. They might have flipped the house and made a ton of money. We can now watch today and see how people do when equity is going in the other direction. But math doesn't lie. Those expenses we used were pretty conservative. We didn't even get into advertising costs if you lose your tenants, lost revenue for when you have vacancies, legal costs for evictions, and a bunch more. Now, admittedly, there are certain tax benefits to owning this rental, but there's tax benefits for owning any business without investing that money or taking that amount of headache on. Now, most people think of a house as an investment that's cash, but in reality is quite illiquid, especially when the market is down. It can be very difficult to free up your cash quickly if you need to sell this house. Now, are there ways to still make money in real estate? Absolutely, if you think outside the box. We recently did a video on passive investing that shows alternatives. I'm going to place that link above here on the video, as well as options to flip raw land. You might find that interesting. Like and subscribe if you like content like this. Lots more good stuff to come. Thank you for watching.